Hello students, welcome back to my channel. In today's video we are going to discuss about phase rule. So this phase rule is given by Gibbs, so that's why it is also called as Gibbs phase rule. So before going to this, if you are first time to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and tap the bell icon. Now let us move on to our topic, that is phase rule. So this phase rule is applicable only for heterogeneous system. So heterogeneous system, what is meant by a heterogeneous system? So this is, let us consider sodium chloride is dissolved in water and another solution barium chloride is dissolved in water. So the sodium chloride is dissolved in water, it forms a homogeneous system. This is a homogeneous system. And barium chloride is dissolved in water, it forms a heterogeneous system. This is a heterogeneous system. So here, if you consider this solution, the concentration is same at all points. In this solution, the concentration is same at all points. That's why it is called homogeneous system. If you take barium chloride, this concentration is different at different points. Here, the barium chloride is precipitated at the bottom portion of the container. So that's why the concentration of BaCl2 is more here and the concentration of BaCl2 is less here. So that's why this system is called heterogeneous system. And this system is called homogeneous system. So homogeneous system means any system in which the concentration or chemical composition is same at all points. That is called homogeneous system. In any system, the composition or concentration is different at different portions. That is called heterogeneous system. So this phase rule is applicable only for heterogeneous system. And the heterogeneous system should always in equilibrium conditions. The system should be in equilibrium condition. So what is meant by an equilibrium condition? So if you consider any system, let us consider a water system. This is a system. System means which is under some investigation. That is called system. So if you study the system of water, if you study the properties of water, then water will become the system. So let us consider the water system. So this water is in existing equilibrium condition. So this is water exists in equilibrium condition, that is ice exists in equilibrium with water, exists in equilibrium with water vapor. So here this water exists in three different states, solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. So these three states are under equilibrium condition. If you increase the temperature of ice, it will convert into water. Ice melts and converts into water. If you further increase the temperature of water, it will enter into vapor phase, that is gaseous phase, that it converts into water vapor. So all these three, solid state, liquid state and gaseous state, these three will have same chemical formula, that is water, H2O. H2O has the chemical formula of these three components. Okay. These three exist in equilibrium. That means if you increase the temperature, ice melts and become water. And water, if you increase the temperature, it will convert into water vapor. Suppose if you decrease the temperature of water vapor, it will convert into water. If you further decrease the temperature, it will convert into ice. So this state is called equilibrium condition. So this phase rule is applicable for any heterogeneous system which is under equilibrium condition. Okay. So now let us move on to phase rule. So here, this phase is entirely different from physical state. Phase is different from physical state. You have to remember this point. This phase is different from physical state. Physical state means whether it is solid state, liquid state or gaseous state. But phase, what is meant by phase? So let us discuss about phase further after discussing this phase rule. So now let us move on to phase rule. So this is phase rule. So here F plus P is equal to C plus 2, where F is the number of degrees of freedom and P is the number of phases and C is the number of components. So this phase rule can be stated like this. So the sum of these two is always greater than components by 2. That means the sum of the number of degrees of freedom and the number of phases always exceeds the number of components by 2. So this is the Gibbs phase rule. Okay. The sum of the number of degrees of freedom and number of phases always exceeds the number of components by 2. So now let us discuss about these three terms separately in detail. So now let us discuss about phase. What